Eric Anders is set to go down against Kyle Dakos, and this looks like a great scrap. Eric Anders riding on score of 14-7, won no contest. He lost to Andre Muniz, lost to Jun Young Park, outworked Darren Stewart, was better than Gerald Machard, Vinicius Moreira, lost to Krzysztof Jatko. Eric Anders is a high level opponent, great boxer, brutal punches, fists of fury, that's how I like to call him. 6'1", 75 inches of reach, kickboxing BJJ fighter. Kyle Dacos is more of a BJJ guy, 6'3", 76 inches of reach, Martinez BJJ fighter and black belt in BJJ, purple belt in Muay Thai, 11 wins, 3 losses, 1 no contest. Lost to Roman Dolidze, lost to Phil Hoss and Brandon Allen, defeated Dustin Stoltz. Kevin Holland fight was so unlucky, he won that fight but no contest and head clash. They watched the replay, it really was a head clash, but rules are pretty much strict and he choked out Jamie Pickett. I think it's either going to be a knockout victory for Eric Anders or submission victory for Kyle Dacos. Kyle Dacos offers pretty much decent takedown offense, but here is the problem. Clinch defense is critical for him, plus Eric Anders is master in cage control. These are two weaknesses for Kyle Dacos. Hence, if the fight gets dragged to the ground, I think he will have good chances of submitting Eric Anders. Eric Anders is better in the stand-up from what I've seen. I mean, Dacos knows to punch. It's not Dacos knows to box. I'm not criticizing him. I'm just saying that Eric Anders is better in the stand-up. Well, I see Dacos as a better guy on the mat. So this is going to be a hard scrap to choose, but I'm going to go with Dacos because Anders is on a two-fight losing streak. Dacos just got knocked out by Roman Dolidze. I hope he's going to bounce back. And I see Dacos as a slightly more well-rounded fighter.